Hey, it's Ricardo, and as you will probably tell by the title, I am building Vincent from the Black Hole. Now, today I'm going to concentrate on Vincent's head, or in particular, the helmet, the top piece, not the eyes. Now, here I am in Simplify 3D. Simplify 3D is the slicer of choice that I am currently using with my CR10S4. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get these individual sections because the helmet area that you can see on the screen is too big for the build plate. If I'd had the money and sprung for a bigger build plate, I could have printed it all out in one go. But would that necessarily been the most efficient use of plastic and the best way of printing the model? I soon found out that having a build plate doesn't mean you necessarily have to build things all in one go. And splitting things up into smaller pieces tends to be the right way to go. As you can see here, I've taken half of the helmet, I joined them together and I'm trying different orientations. This orientation here would have meant I would have wasted quite a bit of plastic and not had a really good finish on the curvature of the helmet because of supports that would have had to have been from the build plate to the top of the helmet. There would have been supports in the inside along around the rim area as well. So that wasn't the best orientation to print this particular piece in, and it was quite big and quite unwieldy. All that aside, now we're going to break it apart and we're going to ungroup it. We tried another orientation. This orientation here would have ensured a really good outside clean print. However, there would be an awful lot of wasted plastic inside. A support for the arch of this part of the helmet would have wasted a hell of a lot of plastic. So, what am I going to do here? Well, fortunately, the person who I got the files from for Vincent included files for smaller printers. Now, some of these printers can have like a 200 or 300 print bed, whereas I've got a 400. You think, well, am I really getting enough out of this printer? So, I decided to go with smaller pieces and do them over several prints over time. And as you can see here, I'm joining up two sections to make a part of a quadrant that will make the entire circular dome. So I've gone into Simplify 3D, I'm merging two pieces together, I'm going to match up the best I possibly can, so there's going to be no gaps, and if there is, only be a bit of light sanding. They're now grouped, I can then rotate this particular model around the build plate, and I should need minimal amount of supports here to support the plastic. So what do I mean by supports? So as you get past a certain angle within 3D printing, that print is going to need supports to build the next layer, as you can see here in the sort of the light green. Those print supports are being put in by the software to ensure that you get a decent print. Now, sometimes you don't need them, but a lot of the time that you actually do. Otherwise, your print's going to sag, you're not going to get really good quality, and it's going to spoil the entire finish of your print. Now, if you're printing for like between 6 and 12 hours per particular piece, that's really going to spoil your day. So let's take a look at some of the settings we've got inside Simplify 3D for this print. Now, I can honestly say on these first initial pieces, it has really been a huge learning experience. Getting to grips with Simplify 3D. Infill. How much of your print do you want infilled with interior supports? How dense do you want it to be? I'm going to up this to about 20% because I want a really good infill density and I want a bit of strength as well. How big is the nozzle diameter going to be? Well, I'm currently using a 0.6 print head. So as a result of this, I should be able to print faster and I'm not going to need too much detail on this particular piece. Exterior layers, how many solid layers do you have before the infill starts? All these things have to be considered and all have an impact on how much plastic you use, which is going to be many, and then how much time your printer's running for. Again, with electricity, it's going to be money as well, and time of the print bed and how long this project's going to take. So I'm currently printing at 65 millimeters per second, which sounds like it's really quick, and I suppose it is. We've got a good temperature, currently it's set to 210. I'm going to drop that down to the lower 200s, 203. I've had it dialed in for this particular filament, and that works for me. The filament I'm using is Sunlube filament. It's really good, PLA Plus. You can get it on Amazon, I'll put the links in the window or in the chat window and you can all take a look at that. I've had really good results, nice silky smooth and low odour as well. With a heated print bed, I am using a heated print bed, but I'm going to typically only use that for the first couple of layers. Because what I found, especially in the summer months, when you know the ambient temperature is higher than what it would be in the frosty old winter, you're not going to need it so much. And of course, it saves a little bit on the power as well. So I'm going to turn the heated bed off after a good couple of layers. Now, fan speed is also very important in your cooling, because you've got a fan set in front of what effectively is a CNC-controlled glue gun head. The fact that you're feeding it with PLA filament is irrelevant. That's effectively what it is. And you want to cool that plastic down when it's extruded onto the bed of the surface of the bed of your printer, so that it adheres, it sticks, you get a good level of adhesion as well, and you don't have any gaps in the layers. All these things are learning experience. Simplify 3D has a really good website where it goes through all the typical problems that you're going to see with a print and what you can do within their software to fix this. Now, if you're using other software like Cura as well, then that's going to, you know, it's going to translate. There's going to be very sort of similar functions you can have in there, but there's so much information out there on the internet. You know, it's very difficult to go wrong. Although, you know, let's face it, I have wasted in this print quite a few things getting things right. Even though I started off with smaller items and not so grandiously big parts of V.i.n.c.e.n.t as what I've done. So typically there's my model, I'm all set up and I'm ready to go, it's all grouped. I can rotate it on the bed to get the best orientation as well for printing. All this can potentially cut down on time and how far the print head of the printer will take when traveling across the entire model. So with all that decided, I'm going to go ahead now and I'm going to say, right, begin the printing process. Now when you begin the printing process, it goes away. And it typically says, right, you're going to use this amount of plastic and that's how long it's going to take. So typically each of these prints took about 6 hours, and with this speeded up representation here, which can be quite boring to be perfectly honest, and it's a bit like watching paint dry, you can typically see that when it's finished you get a nice uniform print, a little bit of cleanup, a little bit of detail with sanding, but that's to be expected. But I'm generally happy with the results. Some of the support structures in here, you know, were necessary. And when it was all joined together in all its segments, you can see it does look like V.i.n.c.e.n.t's helmet. Ooh, misses. But with a bit of filler, bit of Bondo, bit of that car filler, some light grade sanding as well, I was very happy with the result. On the top here, where I've joined all the quadrants, or whatever they're called, octets together for this particular hat, it was a bit scruffy in the middle around the circle. Things didn't fit exactly how I wanted them to. I mean, there was shrinkage, different types of PLA that I'd use, which is the filament for the 3D printer. However, V.i.n.c.e.n.t's head was looking quite nice and uniform and glued together, and I'd used a soldering iron as well inside to sort of weld things together. And with a bit of sanding, it was looking better. But I really did need to have some sort of a ring on the top. So for that, I went back into Simplify 3D and just constructed a small ring using some of the tools there and some of the shapes that are readily available on the internet to create a ring that would fit round as a sort of a cowl around the top of that helmet centerpiece. All well and good, not too difficult to find the sort of ring that I was looking for, and I sizing it and measuring the model to see where the differential was and how distorted it was from fitting the quadrants or octets together on V.i.n.c.e.n.t's head. I increased the height a little bit to make sure that it stood a little bit proud, so I could then fill that in with filler, and then increased the diameter of this so that it would fit snugly over the top, and also provide a little bit of extra strength in keeping the sections of the head together. Even though it was glued together and welded together with my soldering iron and I put screws through it and all the rest of it, I didn't want it splitting. Especially I went to get onto the painting stage and the finishing stage, because that would just be soul destroying and would be really, really bleak. So with that problem solved now, and having the ring inserted on the top part of V.i.n.c.e.n.t's head, I was able to finish additional sanding make sure all the surfaces were smooth, and then off it went to be primed. Once it was primed, it then came back from the spray shop with some nice Ford silver sprayed onto it as well. But looking inside, you know, I mean, it's not very pretty inside as you'd expect, but no one's going to be looking at the inside of the head. I've welded it with the soldering iron, I've used some silicone sealant, I've had some brackets in there as well to give it that extra strength, and with that small circular bracket or cowl on the top holding it all together, it is quite strong as well. It's a really good finish. I'm really happy. You can see your face in it as well, and that top part doesn't look out of place either. Certainly looks better than what it did originally. Now there's still some detailing to do. Even with the face plate on it and the rest of the body attached, it looks like Vincent. However, as soon as you get that enamel paint out and you start putting in the details of the eyes and the face, as we like to call it, it looks completely different. And it does look exactly like what you're trying to build. I've been Ricardo, and I'm building Vincent. Thanks very much for watching on how I built the head for Vincent. More videos coming up soon of other body parts. Hope you stay tuned and check them out. See you soon.